It's the deadliest pro wrestling event of the calendar year. It's Cage of Death 15, presented by Combat Zone Wrestling. Live on CZWIPPV.com on Saturday, December the 14th at 7:30 p.m. from the Flyer Skate Zone in Voorhees, New Jersey. Inside this year's deadly structure will be Drew Blood alongside the Bulldozer Matt Tremont, Rory Mondo, and Ron Mathis taking on the Nation of Intoxication. For tickets and complete details, visit czwrestling.com. Combat Zone Wrestling, it's like nothing else.
Drew, I love you to death. You know that. We've been up and down 9.5 years. Been everywhere. Our careers are on the line, buddy. As much as I love you, I'm not ready to hang up my boots. And so you better bring your A game, because my reputation in 2 weeks is on the line. So Drew, be ready, because at home sweet home, I'm declaring this bitch my home sweet home.
You know what? You talk about how you carried me through all these years. I remember when I went back to a company and I was a goddamn job boy for 4 years. But I stayed there to support you. It's your career and mine. But there's one thing that you, and I know you, Dev, you haven't thought about. Have you seriously even considered the consequences of the loss in this match? It's done. Over with. And I'm ready to deal with that. But my question is, are you? I'm ready to do what it takes. And I mean whatever. You're the one that threw this friendship out the window. So come July 10th, we'll see who stands longest, and we'll see who's going to walk out that front door. I never thought I'd see this day, Dev. But this day's coming, and I think I'm ready.
There's a famous scene where Trent Acid and Devin Moore come off a scaffold just like this against each other, and Devin Moore is paying tribute to that man right now.
Good.
Oh, God! Oh! Jesus Christ! Do you believe that? Not at all. And this crowd comes alive for the risk these men are taking to save their own careers.
If Bud can get the cover, this is it.
This gotta be it. Oh! Good thing Devin Moore was so close to the ropes. There's no way he would be able to kick out of that.
There's that big right hand coming into play.
This is it. If someone goes through that glass, their career is over tonight.
These two men are throwing hands and apparently heads.
Oh, come on.
He's got him up.
Oh, tombstone.
There's the cover.
Oh, and that tombstone was almost the death of Devin Moore's career. But he was able to kick out. And now Drew Blood is saying, this is really it. This will be the end of Devin Moore's career.
He's got him hooked.
Whoa.
Oh, Moore with the counter. Oh, headbutts. Oh, he's got him up. Oh, he's got him up.
Cut it off. Sweet Jesus, got him. Devin Moore will continue his quest in CZW. His career continues. But on the sad side of things, this is the last time we will ever see my good friend, Drew Blood, in CCW. And I'm sure, on behalf of everyone in the locker room, Drew, it's been awesome knowing you. Welcome to stop by and hang out with us anytime. If your career's over the ring, but you're friends with us all forever.
To wipe out his opponent, but also landing on his feet, doing less damage to himself in the process. And Devin Moore's gonna need an advantage like that if he wants to put away the former ultra-violent Golden Boy in Drake Younger.
Fighting out on the outside, all across Markland. Acres! Whipping Drake Younger right into that guardrail. But I think had to move in the last 3 turns.
Oh, look at that though, Drew Blood! He doesn't want to see these guys get any more violent against each other, taking away that barbed wire baseball bat from Devin.
Well, this is a scaffold match.
And Devin Moore goes into a sea of inhumanity, courtesy of Drake.
Now look at that Irish whip into the casket.
Oh, Danny Havoc. Oh, God. Oh, God, he saw it sticking right in his back.
Clinging to the flesh of Rory Mondo was that barbed wire, and now Danny Havoc's in the zone. He's drunk, he's angry, and he wants the blood of Mondo on his hands.
Oh God, he's tying it tying that barbed wire right around him.
It's gonna let
him where Mondo goes, it's not gonna be pretty.
Jesus! Talk about not pretty.
Mondo going up top, but that might not be smart, as Danny Havoc stuns Mondo up top. Havoc is gonna, oh no.
He's got him on his shoulders. He's gonna try and put him on his shoulders.
He's gonna, looks like he might be going for an assault driver. Oh, I can't tell yet.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
An inebriated assault driver.
Oh, God.
Oh!
Right into the coffin.
Well, he's got 5 seconds.
Danny Havoc now putting all of his weight on top of the door.
Bundy rules with the count in this one.
Oh, no. So close.
No.
And he emerges from the casket.
The problem is, he just opened the goddamn door. He's still got to sit up.
Yeah, he's still wrapped. He's still entangled in barbed wire.
He opened the door to his own destruction. Oh, Mondo.
Smart
able to
count.
Evade it.
Trying.
No. Don't.
No. This is not good. No, Danny. No, God. No, please don't.
The referee needs to be counting right now. The referee needs to be counting right now. This match should be over.
Oh, thank God, the lighter is not working. No, Shawnee, what the hell is he doing?
Shawnee's on the take.
Why would you assist with this?
Oh,
come
Jesus
on.
Christ.
Havoc, it was you and me in a mummified barbed wire match. That means the casket is completely covered from front to back to inside to out in barbed wire. And what happened was you put me in there, you're about to win the match fair and square. Shit happens, that's the way wrestling goes. And I understand that it's tournament of death. And you gotta take it one step further, don't you? Because you're the death match drunkard. You're the guy that gets drunk before his matches. You're the guy that does drugs before his matches. And you sit there like the fucking loser that you are. And you took a bottle of lighter fluid. And you tried to fucking burn me alive. And I understand that the fans were very happy about that, but I don't care about them because they don't mean shit. So I'm in this business for me and me only. Saturday, I'm never gonna forget this, Danny Havoc. So I will rack you up in barbed wire just like you did to me. Only this time, there's no escaping it. I will light you on fire. do the world a favor and put you out forever.
He's eyeing up the use of that table. Well, we got another official. Wait, what? Super bomb!
What the hell is he doing?
I don't know what just happened.
He wasn't even making the damn count. He's the worst referee we had.
Oh, good. He deserved that.
What the hell? He's a trick.
Chainsaw Joe Gacy.
Forever, man. Forever. That's a long son of a bitch time. And time waits for no man, Devin Moore. I sat back on the shelf for 3 years when I lost the Loser Leaves CZW match. I was there when you won the title. Where the fuck was my invite for the after party? I'm supposed to be your best friend. I'm back. Full-fledged Drew motherfucking Notorious Blood. And Devin, you think I'm gonna come at you right away and give you the fight you want? Nah. I'm gonna let you sit and fester over time. Think about how bad you wanna get in the ring with me. Because when it's time, Devin, I want the inner scumbag. I want that notorious scumbag, Devin Moore, to be in the ring when I look at him eye to eye and say, this is it, motherfucker. This is the fight. This is the last fight we'll probably ever have. Because either one of us ain't walking out of here. Who is in whose shadow? We'll find out, Devin. I'll let you know the time. But it ain't right now.
For years, I've carried you on my fucking back. Nobody wanted you around. I used to stick up for you. Oh, Drew's a good guy. He's got a good heart. And what do? You stab me in the fucking back! But it's okay. You lit a fire, Ray. Fuck your Drew bullshit. Ray fucking Williams, you lit a fire under me. I haven't had that fire in a while. And then, I'm gonna fuck you up. Simple as that. Ty, Maven, Fat Ass Deej, I don't give a fuck. You get him back in the fucking ring. And I hope you're ready, because just like they say, I'm the Michaels, you're the fucking Jannetty, bitch.
Don't steal any fucking CZW DVDs from the table tonight.
I had no idea his Christian name wasn't Drew Blood.
We're not showing up tonight!
Uh-oh.
Fuck you, Lucky's Blood!
Wait a second, it's Rory Mondo! Rory Mondo in attacking the Nation of Intoxication!
He's had a problem with Danny Havoc ever since Tournament of Death, when Havoc tried to set him on fire.
Wait a second, it's not done yet. Here comes Ron Mathis now.
Ron Mathis is now Devin Moore with the barbed wire bat.
All hell has broken loose as we kick off Tangled Web 6.
Are you asking the bald man in a suit to make a tag team match play on?
I'll tell you what, the look on Drew Blood's face is priceless. He wants to get his hands on the Nation, but he doesn't want any part of Devin Moore, who was not originally scheduled for this match later on tonight. But here we go, Nation Intoxication, wasting no time.
Devin Moore targeted Drew Blood when he was caught off by Mondo and Mathis.
Yes, for those who missed the beginning of tonight's show.
Oh, God almighty!
I'm saying conveniently.
Oh, no.
But nevertheless, the match still happens.
Lucky 13 letting it all hang out.
Nevertheless, the match still happens because they're really after Public Enemy number one, and that's Drew Blood.
What we have right now is six men looking in the eyes of danger. Six men looking in, staring in the face of permanent destruction of their careers, entering into this tangled web, the sixth edition of the most sadistic matchup of the summer.
And Ron Mathis looking at us, making a name for himself here in the combat zone in every big event. First he did a tournament of death, now he's doing it in the most feared match of the summer, the tangled web match.
Though. Bringing Devin to the top for an assault driver.
Oh, Lord almighty. He's looking to end the match now. One, two.
Only a two. And to our left, Danny Havoc and Ron Mathis fighting over that carpet strip barbed wire contraption. Oh, Lord. Opportunity he yearned for to main event in combat zone wrestling, but at what cost is he going to do it at?
Devin Moore.
Oh, birdie kick.
He missed with the birdie.
Oh, no.
Devin Moore being destroyed here tonight at Tangle Web 6.
Body first in that.
Could be it, not enough.
Body first in that flesh piercing barbed wire.
Oh,
you know, all throughout the springtime, we saw Drew Blood, what we thought make were questionable calls, but as it turns out, they were actually plots against the Nation.
Yeah, you're exactly right.
Oh, this is what Devin Moore's been waiting for.
Here we go, the former Notorious Inc. dead center in the middle of the ring, and Devin Moore wants Drew Blood to stab him right in the face right now.
28 days later, Moore finally. 28 days later, Moore thought he was finally going to get his hands on Drew.
On CVWrestling.com, Drew Blood said he's not going to give Devin Moore what he wants. He's going to make sure Devin Moore is pretty much the whole Nation Intoxication will be down and out for Devin Moore. Or excuse me, for Drew Blood gives Devin Moore the match. What the hell is he doing?
Drew Blood is leaving his partners. It's a struggle. Which one of these athletes is going to gain control and send their opponent through that barbed wire? Oh, God.
Oh, Lord almighty. That's got to be it. One, two, and there's Mathis in to break up the three count.
Both men struggling as they fight it out to get to that top turnbuckle.
Okay, I said it before. Ron Mathis has made a name for himself at every big event of 2013. And he can quite possibly put an exclamation point on his 2013 here at Tangle Web 6.
What could be going through the mind of Mathis? Dangerous intentions, but look at Havoc.
Oh! Oh!
You want it? If Mondo wants it, Devin Moore is going to take it out on him. Mondo wants to align himself with Drew Blood. That does not sit well with Devin Moore, the notorious scumbag.
We're almost at the ceiling. And Mondo's going for another assault driver. Devin Moore trying to brace himself. Devin Moore does it, using the ceiling to his advantage. Oh no. Oh God. This is why he's assault, but it's, oh God almighty! They just killed! Rory Mondo is dead! The man is dead! Seen anything like that before? Devin Moore risking life and limb to make sure Rory Mondo may not walk again. No man in this match has any regard for his opponent, and they're willing to demonstrate that at extreme costs. How the hell are Mathis and Havoc even standing right now? I don't know, after what they just did moments earlier, going through that barbed wire and those carpet strips. They're running on more than adrenaline. They're proving why they are the toughest athletes in this or any other sport.
Oh, no.
Oh. Mathis, that inverted pile driver, his knee saved by his pads.
Recovery, one, two, and kick out before a count of three.
And that's the reason why Danny Havoc is a TOD 7 and 12 winner. The resiliency. But now the anger, it's expressed by Mathis, and the clans are taking him out in very sadistic and ultra-violent ways. His first main event in the combat zone, Mathis wants to make this count.
Count, but he's in the ring with the deathmatch trunk. He's in the ring with the Nation of Toxication.
Oh, Lord.
Look at the way he folded there. I think Danny Havoc just ordered Devin Moore to go back atop the scaffold.
But Drew Blood.
Wait a second.
Trying to forcefully pull Devin Moore off that scaffold.
Oh, look.
The brutalizing the skull of Blood with that chair.
This could be it. This is the makeshift team of Mathis, Mondo, and Blood. They are not enough to this tight group. These three men, the Nation of Intoxication, are brothers.
Devin Moore. What's got to be, oh my God! Are you shitting me?
One, two, three.
Have you ever seen men put an exclamation point on what they're trying to accomplish? That those they're trying to terminate, quite like the Nation of Intoxication did here tonight at Tangled Web 6.
The Nation of Intoxication are the rulers of deathmatch wrestling right now.
But I will say, there's no affection in this. I don't want to be friends. I don't want to go to the bar afterward, but I got to give credit where it's due. You two are a hell of a lot tougher than I ever expected. I tell you, one reason I have a hell of an action here. Why don't you watch this right now? I got no reason to be for you.
Get the fuck out!
Let's go out! Next time!
Of Devin Moore, quite honestly. Because Devin Moore retired him in the first place. Oh, wait a second, Lucky missing with the kick. Ducking the clothesline, off the ropes he goes again. Wheelbarrow catching it into a stunner. Off the ropes he goes, kick to the face. And wait a second, what the hell? What the hell is this?
Relentless Ron Mathis.
Are you kidding me? Ron Mathis in here. Oh, there's Devin Moore. Yes!
Devin Moore is absorbing the shot from Blood. See, Blood's not scared.
Are you kidding me? He's running away from the man.
He's challenged him to a race. This is how they're going to settle their differences.
Yeah, we better start moving. Down there's Ron Mathis. Here comes Danny Havoc now. The last member of the Nation coming to the aid of Lucky and Devin Moore right now. Danny Havoc still has a battle. An ultra-violent battle with Rory Mondo still coming up. Oh, there's Rory Mondo now.
And it looks like the issues that we thought may have been settled at Tangled Web 6 were not settled at all. That was just the beginning.
No, definitely not. I want to know how the hell Drew Blood has ride a guy like Ron Mathis. Ron Mathis, who made a statement on his own. This crowd loved the man at Tournament of Death, loved the man all summer, and Drew Blood has warped his mind, and I guess Rory Mondo's to an extent, to help him in his war against the Nation.
Hey, look, these men are trying to build their careers. What better way to do it than join Drew Blood in his mission to take out the Nation once and for all?
Right now, Mathis.
So it looks like the ultra-violent rules matchup has officially begun.
I don't know. I'm not quite sure.
Hey, well, maybe Mondo, not. You guys are gonna fight so bad. Squad, give me some weapons. Also, my rules right now.
Well, there you have it from our vice president, Maven Bentley. The match has officially started. The ultra-violent rules contest.
Up and over, and look how hard Havoc just sends himself into that steel guardrail.
I think he's gonna try to impale the man.
I think he is. That looks like it's on his agenda.
No. Oh God, this is not. Danny Havoc, stop it. Oh God. Oh, Jesus Christ. Stop the damn match.
Rory Mondo asked for this.
Oh, that's gotta be a one, two, and only a two count.
Rory Mondo has taken his game to another level tonight.
Yes, he has, but Danny Havoc is, I think, taking it to an even further level.
Oh, my God.
Did they rip the door off of DJ Hyde's bedroom?
Wait a minute. Sellers, look at all the people in the crowd that want one.
The strength of Rory Mondo. Oh, God. Oh, no! Jesus!
No! Why would he do that? Oh, my God.
Danny Havoc is done.
You've got to be kidding me. We've seen Danny Havoc go through the depths of hell in ultraviolet wrestling. He won in this match with cracked ribs, still from Tournament of Death.
Yes, I was about to say
Mondo
that.
And Mondo has been taking advantage of that.
Yeah. I think he just completely broke the rib right there. If not, put that chair leg right through his damn abdomen.
This match has just been a nightmare for both men's bodies. And Rory Mondo almost looks frustrated, unable to show what to do. Wow. Danny Havoc may have suffered a serious, serious injury.
Yeah, you see the referee, Chris Levin, there, holding up the X.
For New Jack.
No, it's not for New Jack.
Ladies and gentlemen, after speaking with the official,
He has called this match a no contest.
Yeah, Danny Havoc. Yeah.
I don't really know what else to add. These men gave their all tonight. Oh, what the hell?
He has a goddamn weed whacker. Now put that away.
Are you shitting me?
Put that away.
Mondo. Mondo's taking it too far.
Devin Moore and Lucky 13 out trying to stop Rory Mondo, but he's wielding that damn weed whacker around.
Yeah, even Moore and Lucky.
You see Maven Bentley out here. The weed whacker has been used in CZW in the past, and it's actually why in the Athletic Commission's rule book, it's a banned weapon in professional wrestling.
Sophie's choice, his job, or what he tried to set out to do tonight, the destruction of Danny Havoc.
He fucking quit! Danny Havoc, quit! Get up!
He's saying he quit. He didn't quit. The damn man is injured, for crying out loud.
But you see that weed whacker that Mondo possessed, the one weapon that no one in CZW will stare face to face with. And will, oh my God!
God almighty! Are you kidding me? Are you freaking kidding me? The man's injured.
And you see Danny Havoc's blood brothers.
Yeah, they're taking Rory Mondo out.
Rory!
Yo, Rory, come here, man.
What?
Yo.
You fucking bailed on us last month.
Listen, man. Listen.
Fuck you, what?
Look. Dude, I'm sorry about last month. My emotions got the best of me. But remember, I gave you the opportunity. So just hear me out. Okay?
Speak.
I came in here. My team bailed on me. The guys who have my back. But you're proving that you have my back. I got my beef with Devin. And you got your beef with Danny. But I want to let you know this. You know he's not out. He's not out yet. This is just the beginning. So I need me and you to stick together. Do you trust me? We ain't gotta like each other, but we just gotta trust each other. I'm just leaving it at that. Think about it, Rory. Think about it.
2013. Trials and tribulations, pain and agony. Because of one man and one man only, Joe Gacy. You see, what proceeded to happen in that ring tonight, I wasn't shooting, I was speaking from the heart. And I aired my frustrations towards this promotion and towards you, Joe. Bulldozers, House of Horrors. Because that's exactly what you've done for the last 8 months. When I sit at home and I look at the wall and I see Joe Gacy's name written on it, because my life has been truly a House of Horrors. And like I said, I have been salivating at the fingertips, and now the blood will flow, Joe. House of Horrors, me and you, one-on-one. And for the first time since Cage of Death, Tremont's gonna be relevant again. And for the first time in a long time, you will hear me, fear me, and everybody, including you, will believe me.
Call you back.
Yeah, I got it.
just want to say, great fucking job last month, Tanner Webb. You proved that you're a freaking team player. I don't know why you are a wrestler, but I said that, you know, give Mathis a match tonight. But you held my back tonight against Lucky. And I want to thank you for it.
I'm going to stop you right there. You don't need to thank me. All you have to do is keep getting me on the show like you promised when we initially started. That's all I want, spots on shows.
Well, you wanted your opportunity. I just got done talking to Maven. So next month, you have Lucky one-on-one. Lucky 13, one-on-one.
A singles match.
Singles match. If Lucky wins, Dev gets a shot at me, so I really need you to pull through on this one for me, man.
And out of everything you just said, all I heard is I got a singles match. When I make this 9-hour drive here, I'm not coming to lose. I'm coming to win. So don't worry about it.
Well, you got your spot. All right? I guarantee it. Trust in me, man. Trust in me.
Mathis catches him. Lucky going for that standing slice bread. Oh, there's that high impact running knee to the face. Maybe the knockout shot. Cover one, two. Oh, come on. Drew Blood now jerking Levent to the outside. And finally, I hope Drew Blood gets some brownie points with everybody after that.
Blood doing whatever he can to avoid an inevitable counter with Devin Moore, postponing it for as long as possible.
All that on the line right now. It looks like Mathis has got something. Brass knuckles, it looks like.
Devin Moore rushing the ringside area, grabbing Ron Mathis. Ah, drops him
with a crusher, and Moore coming back with a brainbuster
again.
Stuffing the weapon in the Mathis's tights.
Devin Moore signaling to the back.
He wasn't an official.
Rory
Mondo. Devin Moore.
Nice to see you, Rory.
And a
senior combat zone official Nick Papagiorgio in the ring. Cover one, two.
Oh,
two
Mathis.
Count only.
Mathis still. As we had all hell breaking loose on the outside.
Vice President Maven Bentley out now trying to restrain Rory Mondo.
Oh man, Mondo snapping once again.
Mondo now taking on security and anyone in his path.
Mondo and Moore went at each other.
All control's been lost in this one.
Oi! Breaking the ribs of Danny Havoc last time out was Mondo.
Lucky and Ron Mathis coming to blows once again in the center of the ring.
We got a fight everywhere inside of those guardrails.
Lucky mounting a flurry of offense off the rope. Oh, Drew Blood once again. Ron Mathis going for the tombstone. Nails it.
Spinning tombstone. Get an
no referee
the ring.
To make the cover. Nick Papagiorgio. One, two, three.
And
that's it.
And it looks like Devin Moore will not get his match with Drew Blood anytime soon. The chaos that ensued outside of the ring.
Hold on for a second. Devin Moore signaling to Nick Papagiorgio to check him.
Boy, he's got nothing.
Nick Papagiorgio demanding Mathis empty his tights.
All right, let's go. Come
what?
On. The
hell is Where'd that come that? From? Well, it looks like, I don't really know what's going on, but it looks like we're going to give him the mic. It looks like all the chaos that ensued, the distraction caused by the brawl on the outside, Drew Blood costing.
I waited 9 months for ultraviolence. I was salivating at the fingertips. And I drew blood from every ounce of my body tonight as I waged war with another man because the House of Horrors became a reality. 9 months. The Combat Zone faithful forgot about me. And the Chainsaw had the better of me time and time again. But not tonight. Because tonight I was back in my element. My world. Because Joe Gacy stepped into my world. And I gave you people what you've wanted since 1999. But there's still a void I need to fill. And I'm still feeling some kind of way. But I guarantee, in November, it truly will be a night of infamy. Because now, the entire wrestling world will hear me again. Fear me again. Believe me again.
You know, it's a rare thing to hear this around here these days. Good job. There ain't no reason to be content no more. You got somebody that believes in you, man. Just open your eyes. Look into the light, brother. Just look into the light. Well, you got what you wanted. I told you, there's a little twist. There's a stipulation going to this. Ultraviolet scumbag rules. Both of our team members handcuffed to each other in each corner. 4 mystery boxes in the ring. We're gonna beat the living shit out of each other. And in one of those boxes is the keys to the handcuffs. When you get that key, it allows you to unlock your partners and becomes a 3-on-1 fucking massacre. And I know yous guys want that. Yous guys want that in the worst way. Yous guys want to tear me the fuck apart. So I'm going to give you the opportunity. Night of Infamy, Drew Blood, Devin Moore. Notorious Sink, 1-on-1, face-to-face, Ultraviolent Scumbag Rules. I know for a fact you cannot say no to that. I'll see you at Night of Infamy.
Face crusher! Right through that barbed wire board!
Let's go, Dev!
Swinging Super Dave Crusher through that barbed wire board. Both men being ripped apart by that barbed wire now. Who got the worst of it? I don't know.
It wasn't pretty for anybody involved, but like we've already noted, the keys are in the box closest to the entranceway.
Moore is up.
The keys to victory, and I think Devin Moore.
Come on, Dev.
Smart. Right now, I think Devin Moore is really just worried about victory, and you can't blame him. He wants to pin Drew Blood.
Reminiscent from that match 3 years ago right now. Devin wanted to settle this mano a mano.
The handcuffs are way too tight.
Blood had other plans.
Behind you!
You said if he was smart, he's going to be going over the corner, but it's not a matter of logic. It's a matter of pride.
You're right. You're absolutely right. Birdie kick following up with a macho elbow.
Ah, he killed him that.
Into the thumbtack cover. That's got to be it. 2.
You got to get us out, Deb.
And
Devin,
still, that's
one
more the
box. You got to get us out.
Blue Blood is hatred killer right now, and that's why he won't go down.
No, wait a minute. This is scumbag rules, right? So Devin Moore, he came up with the rules for this contest,
no,
right?
Drew Blood did. Drew Blood did.
Yes.
Let's go!
But Devin Moore knows what's inside. The key to victory. No.
What?
Kidding me?
What the hell just happened here?
Yeah, bringing that up. Drew Blood made the rules. He probably also put together the boxes.
Oh! Blood taking Moore down right now.
What's going on?
He's got the key in his boot. He put the box together, put the key in his boot.
Why the competitors shouldn't be in construction also. Drew Blood just outsmarted everybody.
Devin, stop him.
Me. Hey, give us the key.
The demented mastermind who was in the heads of Mathis and Mondo also got in the head. got the head of Devin Moore, luring him into this trap.
Give it to us! It's only fair!
Danny Havoc's gonna fight one-armed.
He's like an evil genius, quite frankly.
Demented Mastermind, evil genius to someone else here.
Dev, you gotta get up, you gotta get that key! Dev, you gotta get that key!
And look at all Danny Havoc and Lucky can do is just watch on as they are handcuffed to that corner.
Who the hell is Devin Moore gonna kick him? Where the hell is Devin Moore gonna get help now? His best friends are handcuffed!
I don't know how to
do it! It's Matt Tremont!
Double stunner, Tremont! Not liking what he saw.
Swinging and missing. He's clearing the ring.
Holy shit.
Danny Havoc escapes with the key.
Yeah, they got that key. Being released by CZW officials.
Now we got a standoff in the ring right now.
Matt Tremont clearing house.
On the side of the nation.
What the hell? Are you fucking kidding me?
What did we just see?
What the hell is wrong with this man? What the hell is wrong with him? Are you kidding me?
Matt Tremont saw the light that Drew Blood told him about.
It comes to you, Danny.
Look
Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you! Fuck you, Danny Havoc! Let me tell you a story, Danny! And I'm gonna tell you
right
in your face! You see? My friends!
Shut the fuck up! Shut the fuck up!
Wanda! Wanda! 2013! You gotta be coming out! Something new for me! Is that what you're saying? What's the one I'm saying? You see, Danny? You're my best friend! And you forgot about me!
Fuck you!
I'm here because of you, Danny! But guess what? Now, Mathis, Magno, Blood, and Street Fight, I'm gonna take out, dismay, destruct, and destroy the nation inside the kingdom of death! Show up next month more than a payday. Come to work, bro. Danny, put your fucking boots on and be hungry like a wolf again. Because it's 2005 and you're gonna have to pay your dues. And you're from a smiling motherfucker in this business. And Rocky, Rocky, my brother, you just caught up in the mirror.
Nation on December 14th live on CCW IPPV.com at Cage of Death 15. It's a 4-on-3 fight right now though.
Cage of Death 15. I'm looking shocked at what I have just seen. I would never thought I would see the day that Tremont would curse the combat zone.
He promised to kill the hardcore heroes of the combat zone, and he's doing it right now. This new alliance heading into Cage of Death 15 has perhaps made the biggest statement of all in CZW history.
Matt Tremont, you joined Drew Blood, Rory, Mathis. Because, you know, they're there for you all the time, you know. They got you your job. They looked out for you. They did a lot for you, didn't they? Nah, that was us. And you bit the hand that fed you. Cage of Death, we're going to fuck you four up. Tell them, Danny.
Honest to God, if it weren't for you two motherfuckers, I probably would have quit by now because every single person that I have trusted, put faith in, and called a friend in this goddamn business, this goddamn locker room, has stabbed me in the back. Like, when does this fucking trend end?
Does it?
Tremont, I looked at you like a little brother. Me and Dev, that's 100% legit what he said. You wouldn't be here if it wasn't for us. We got you your job, we looked out for you. How many times did I let you stay with me when you needed a fucking place? How many times did I fucking come over and fucking try and talk you through a rough time? You know, you have your demons and you're trying to deal with them. I was fucking there for you. And this is how you repay me? This is how you repay us? You're a fucking piece of shit. I have no respect for something like that.
You got so mad at us?
Fuck. I don't even... Fucking Matt Tremont. I'm at a loss for words. I don't even know what to fucking say right now. When you first came into the fucking combat zone, nobody knew who you were. You came out and you hung out with us. We brought you out for beers after the show. We were like a fucking family. Sure, we may have grown apart a little bit. Your head may have gotten a little big. We didn't tell the boys that, but yeah, your head's been getting a little big lately. But to come back and fuck us like that, really shows what kind of fucking person you are. Those other three douchebags. We took care of them at Tangle Web.
We'll do it again at the cage.
We'll do it again at Cage. Tremont, we're taking your head fucking off on a fucking platter.
Rory Mondo, I tried to squash the beef between us. I tried to give you respect, a tangled web, and you slapped me in the fucking face. You spent your entire career vainly emulating Sick Nick Mondo. Well, his career ended very early and very violently because he fucked with a man he shouldn't have fucked with. That man was John Zandig. And now you've done the exact same thing. You fucked with a man that you shouldn't have fucked with. So you thought Nick Mondo's career ended violently? You thought he went down in flames? It's nothing compared to what I'm gonna do to you next month.
Pretty much.
Let's go to the bar.
Fuck you guys. They didn't think we could do it. They didn't think I could do it. From Tangled Web, I collectively got a group of guys that were hungry. Hungry for blood. And I made them a promise. I made them a promise. I told them if they stuck by me, I'd guarantee them something glorious. The biggest payoff that anybody could possibly get. They trusted in me. But nobody saw it coming. Nobody saw what I just did out there, coming from a mile away. I took CZW's boyhood superhero and made him the biggest villain that just signed a deal with the devil himself. Just because I made him one promise. Cage of fucking death. You see what happens when you neglect your hero? He tends to turn. Tell him, Maddie. Why don't you tell him, buddy?
You see, what happened, what just happened, in the middle of that ring, I'm gonna have to live with for the rest of my life, but I'm okay with that. Because what just transpired in the middle of that ring with Mondo, Drew Blood, and Ron Mathis was months and months in the making. You see, people look at Matt Tremont since day one. I filled a void and I became your hero, but not anymore. Because this company and you people forgot about me when I became complacent. But it wasn't my fault. And you see, there was one person after the so-called friends that I thought I have neglected me and decided to party more and worry about shenanigans and not taking this company seriously anymore. There was a light in the sky and I climbed the ladder up to the heavens. But see, there was no God, but there was a devil. And this devil's name was Drew Blood. And on December 14th is our Armageddon. Because this company has become a comfort zone and hasn't been ultra-violent in a long fucking time. But now these three men that I've joined alliances with are gonna bring back what this company was built on, and that was ultra-violence, pure unadulterated blood and guts, and it's gonna be at the demise of the Nation of Intoxication. Because on December 14th, the grandest stage of them all, the biggest independent show of the year, it's the NOI against the Unforgotten Ones. Because their blood will be shed all over that structure, and everyone's gonna take us a little bit more seriously. Nation of Intoxication, put your big boy pants on and strap your boots on tight, because we're coming December 14th. You will hear us. You will fear us. And for the first time in a long time, everybody is gonna believe us.